Good evening. My name is Aniela Grisel, salutatorian for the class of 2021, and I'd like to welcome you to tonight's ceremony. Before we begin, please respect the dignity of the occasion and refrain from cell phone use during the ceremony. Thank you. Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem. I pledge allegiance to the flag of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Members of the faculty and fellow classmates. Tonight, we celebrate the completion of another year in our educational journey. Not only that, we also mark the transition from the elementary phase of our learning to the much more challenging years of high school. And yet, despite the significance of this shift, the events of our COVID year make this seem like such a bigger moment. For some graduates on the stage, this is the first public event they've attended in over a year. And for all of us, it is the first time we have all been together since the middle of seventh grade. So, as I stand before you tonight, I welcome you not to a graduation ceremony, but to a graduation celebration. Tonight, we choose not to wallow in all the things we have missed, but to revel in the memories we have shared, the lessons we've learned, and the friendships that will carry us forward into new adventures. Thank you all for coming tonight. Thank you to our parents and teachers for helping us get here, and my fellow graduates. Even during Zoom, we never let teachers have a dull moment. Now let's go to Bret Hart and make up for lost time. Thank you. And now I would like to introduce Allison Pride to give the valedictory address for the AM classes.
Greetings, families and friends of this year's graduating class. Shakespeare is famous for writing that brevity is the soul of wit. In other words, the best way to win over an audience is to keep it short. So in that spirit, I'm going to give my classmates the best graduation gift I can think of and keep it short. Although COVID had a huge impact on this year, we were able to come together and put on this celebration for the class of 2021. I'll never forget this year and how the school was split into three groups, the AM, the PM, and the distance learning students. I am a part of the AM classes, consisting of mostly Angels Camp students. Some of these AM students, me being one, have been going here for 9 years. And for those of you who have been here for less, you were likely Copper Cougars or transfer students from other schools. I'll never forget hearing stories of the PM classes, which have some of my friends in them. Friends. It was hard when all the socializing we got to do was in between classes. I missed hanging out with my friends and going to break and lunch with them this year. Some of us have been friends since preschool and even before that. I'm looking forward to hopefully having a normal high school year with all of you next year. So families and friends of this year's 2021 graduates, let's celebrate our eighth graders in turning them from badgers to bullfrogs. Now I'd like to introduce the valedictorian for the PM classes, Mackenzie Sandoval.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is an honor to be here in front of you all today. I would like to start by saying thank you to my mom and dad, friends, family, and teachers who have helped shape me into the young woman I am today. I've learned amazing things from all the individuals I've had the privilege of knowing at Mark Twain. Thank you all. I came to Mark Twain as a bright-eyed sixth grade student with the thought that I could rule the world. I soon realized that it was harder than I expected. I had the idea that middle school would be just like the shows I saw on TV. I was wrong. Disney shows couldn't have prepared me for the eighth graders who seemed to be twice my size, for a campus that I believed was never ending, or how to understand that Y equals MX plus B, or whatever Mr. Bailey spent 2 months teaching us. What I did have to prepare me was a group of friends who stuck by my side through thick and thin, and I am very grateful for them today. On the first day of seventh grade, I walked into Ms. Turner's class hopeful and ready to learn. My classmates and I were ready to conquer the middle school building. That was until March 13th. We were sent home for what we thought would be 3 weeks, and we were all so excited. 453 days later, and we're just getting back to normal. From online classes to what seemed to be thousands of Google Classroom assignments, it was far from easy. Photomath was our best friend and Zoom was our enemy, but together we overcame it, and together we'll navigate this frightening place called high school. High school is going to be an experience, to say the least. We will meet new people, form new friendships, and embark on new adventures. Everyone loves to give their advice to a graduating eighth grader, especially during a global pandemic, but hey, maybe this advice wasn't too bad and is something I hope we all remember. Never forget who you are, who got you there, and do not change for anyone. Staying true to yourself is the most important thing to hold close to you in high school. There's going to be situations where you may question your values, but if you remember who you are and who you want to be, you'll be okay. I've had so many inspirational figures in my life, my family, my teachers, and my friends. Only recently have I realized that being inspired only takes you so far until you do something about it. The fundamentals of inspiration are fearlessness and a good work ethic without complaint. Hard work pays off. It gets you where you want to be. You get you where you want to be. In the future, inspiration may be all you need to get you started. Remember the fundamentals. Fundamentals are keys. Keys unlock closed doors become open, and open doors become your new opportunities. To wrap this up, we're going to take it all the way back to where we started, kindergarten. Or possibly seventh grade, because we did learn a lot about Dr. Seuss. Remember what Seuss says. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. To my fellow graduates, thank you for making this elementary and middle school experience one to remember. We are growing up now, whether our parents like it or not, so let's do this one step at a time. Thank you. I would now like to introduce our valedictorian for distance learning classes, Lillian Ramos.
This year has been quite the adventure, with both its ups and downs. This year was a year that history will remember. Then, there are those like me who have stayed at home, and we might just remember this whole time being at home. The wise Obi-Wan once said, and yes, I've been watching a lot of Star Wars this year, many of the truths that we cling to depend on our point of view. I believe this means that what we think is important depends on the traits that we value. And these characteristics determine how we approach life's challenges. This year, distance learning certainly had its challenges, and to face these oppositions, we had to get creative. Big problems were computers dying and internet failing. The most frustrating of all was not having the usual school resources to help with the more difficult work. To overcome the distance learning challenges took hard work, perseverance, and positivity. These are some characteristics that form my point of view. Whether you were on the computer or in person, building an education is hard enough without adding the restrictions of COVID to it. We must learn to value things like hard work and not giving up in order to achieve our goals. And sometimes it's really, really hard. It can feel like a winding road filled with potholes and cracking cement that sometimes makes us stumble. And sure, there are times we just want to quit, but holding tight onto what is important guides us through our frustrations. Then once we learn how to trek through the path with creativity and exploring our resources, the journey becomes easier, and then there is no limit to what we can accomplish. Remember that through these difficult times, hold tight onto those characteristics that you think are important and push through the tough times. Go ahead and be creative, be intuitive, and curious. Let's face the next chapter of our lives with whatever characteristics that you cling to and shapes your point of view. And just know that all it takes is the will to succeed, and to start takes one single step. Thank you very much. And yeah, I know I've been chatty, but I've been stuck at home with my parents for an entire year. But one last thing. Thank you, Ms. Bicknell, for this wonderful year. And thank you, all of you, for listening to my speech.
Please welcome members of the Board of Trustees for the Mark Twain Elementary School District. Board President, Mrs. Jenny Eltringham. Mrs. Diane Bateman. Mrs. Kendall Moreland. Mr. Timothy Randall. Mrs. Christy Miro. I would now like to introduce our school principal, Mr. Poe, to give the principal's address.
Good evening, students, staff, school board members, and the Mark Twain families. Welcome to the promotion ceremony for the 8th grade class of 2021. I am Mr. Pogue, and it is my privilege to be the principal here at Mark Twain Elementary School. This is an exciting day, one that our 8th graders have been looking forward for a very long time. Some have attended Mark Twain Union Elementary School District since kindergarten. So this day represents the end of a long chapter in their lives and the beginning of a new and exciting one as they go on to high school. It's only my second year at Mark Twain Elementary School, but the short time that I've known this group of students, I've seen qualities developing in them that will serve them well in high school, in college, and in life in general. Many of these students have started to set life goals for themselves and considered their futures, which has been exciting to watch. Many have worked hard to improve their study skills and their grades in an effort to work towards these goals. A significant number of these students have also grown into leaders and are respected and trusted by their teachers. It has been exciting to watch these students grow and mature through this difficult school year. We will miss them, but we wish them the best and as they move on to high school and towards adulthood. At this point, I'd like to talk to the graduates. Set your goals high, ladies and gentlemen, and don't let anyone or anything distract you from them. Your future is at stake, and your focus and effort during these next 4 years of high school will determine the path you end up on. Keep your eye on the prize and persevere. No matter how tough it might be, we believe in you. Thank you.
We will now begin the presentation of awards. Mr. Rolla will present the History Award, the ACE Scholarship, and the Honorary Badger.
Wow. What a totally unexpected and unplanned standing ovation. Thank you. Wow, we gotta liven it up. How is everybody? I know it's a family show, but I have to say I am so freaking happy to be here together tonight with you good people. You're all looking marvelous. The weather's pretty amazing, a little on the cold side for me. Summer's almost here, and the best part is we get to be together. Kids, what's up? You guys have been pretty quiet. Excited? Okay. Dance is gonna be pretty fun. What was that? You guys know Mr. Swanner used to be a disco expert. Maybe you get him to dance. No, I don't. All right. I got to get started because I got a lot to do up here. And I want to start by saying that I know it was a tough year. It was a year full of drama, some disappointments, concerns about disease, and awkward Zoom conversations. And that was just Mr. Bailey's dating life. Oh, what? Oh, you think that was bad? You guys wanted a rap, and I got some news. Oh my God. I got some news, you're gonna get a rap. But if you thought that was mean, you might be careful what you wish for. All right, before I get to, I know it's your night, but you did not get here on your own, and I do want to acknowledge some other people. I want to start by thanking so many people who made tonight possible. I want to thank Billy Davis and the rest of his crew for coming out, measuring the stage, and then measuring it again, and then again, every time we got new regulations, setting up the chairs, putting the sound system together, all the things to make sure that, honestly, that the health department doesn't arrest me. And I know there were a lot of parents who came to meetings and helped with the dance and all the things, but I do want to single out Amber Shiro and Harmony Skrebecki. I won't make them stand up. They took charge of the PIE fundraiser, and they helped organize parent meetings. And I know they work at the school, but these were extra duties on top of their normal job. And frankly, being on campus only made it easier for me to harass them every time I needed a favor or solve a problem. They approached stressful situations with good humor, something I'm not always good at, and I can always trust them to complete tasks reliably and efficiently. So thanks so much to Harmony and Amber for everything. Oops, put this clap for them, you guys. Okay, but there is one other person I'm gonna highlight for special recognition. In fact, the junior high staff would like to honor her with a special award called the Honorary Badger. This award was actually created way back in the 60s. That's before I was born. So it's a fairly long time ago. And it was meant to honor parents who go above and beyond in their service to the school. Whether that's driving kids to games, participating in fundraisers, decorating for dances, whatever. By tradition, this award is presented to a parent when their youngest child graduates from Mark Twain. When thinking about this award, I reflected back to a conversation the recipient and I had almost exactly 1 year ago. In fact, it was the day after graduation last year, or our kind of graduation. Half jokingly, I sauntered into the front office where she works and announced that I was appointing her the head of this year's eighth grade parent committee. And honestly, I was waiting for her to throw a stapler at me, but instead she looked up and said, "I've already been working on it." And that's how she is. She's such a hard worker. And more than that, to borrow a cliche, she leads with her heart. And I think planning this year's graduation really became something of a mission for her, a way that she could help the kids get back some portion of all the experiences that I know we felt they were missing this year. It must also be said that the Mark Twain front office has become very dependent on her skills and knowledge, which is why we are all sad to have found out that she's leaving us for greener pastures, or should I say a greener lily pad? So for all her effort, dedication, and true Badger spirit, the faculty would like to present the Honorary Badger Award to Jamie Hutchinson. And I'm not gonna, Jamie, you don't have to come all the way down, but Mr. Bailey is going to walk the award, maybe. Well, you're gonna have to go farther than that, Mr. Bailey. Yeah. I gotta send the young guy to do the stairs. Getting too old for that. Jamie, my friend, we love you and we're gonna miss you already. Best of luck at Bret Hart. Okay. Next, I wanna mention a couple of teachers. Please indulge me with this. This past year, we lost former Mark Twain teacher Pat Cohen. Any of you out in the audience who are former Badgers from the 70s, 80s, 90s, that era, will remember Mrs. Cohen? What's the best way I could put it? Miss Cohen was old school. I mean, the real OG of the real OG. And I don't even think she would mind me saying that sometimes she could be a little scary. Like, even on my worst day, my angriest rant, I could never compete with the Miss Cohen death stare. I was gonna stare at you, but I can't even try it. I can't do it. But what I learned as an adult, and the reason I wanted to mention her tonight, is that she loved our school and the children of our community so deeply. Here's one example. Every single year for the last 25 years, Pat Cohen would stop by the front office, this is after she retired, and drop off a check for $50 so that I could give an award to an eighth grade student. Her only instruction to me was, pick somebody good but not perfect, the one you think has been most overlooked. And this will be the first year that I will not be presenting Mrs. Cohen's award. And as sad as that makes me feel, it also makes me proud to know that I get to work with so many dedicated people like her and others. So in memoriam, I'd like to have one last round of applause for Mrs. Cohen. Starting to choke up on that. All right, I also want to mention tonight, really quickly, the retirement of two longtime teachers, Mrs. Cunha and Mrs. Wells. Collectively, these two ladies have had over half a century of teaching experience just in our district. And I must admit, I sort of think of them as the grown-ups on campus. Both of them carry themselves with a quiet gravitas that contrasts nicely with the manic energy of our younger colleagues. Wasn't that a beautiful sentence? I felt like I was describing a glass of wine or something. The manic energy. Look how adorable all the newbies are down there. Okay. I gotta roast the young teachers. I would say that both of these ladies lead by not being flashy or making a spectacle of themselves. That's more my style. But by humbly showing up for work each and every day and doing their work with diligence and grace. Our campuses will be lesser places without them next year. We will miss them deeply and wish them many years of adventure and joy in their retirement. So a round of applause for them. Okay, kids, to you. I'm gonna do the awards first this year. I'm gonna start with the Harold Garner Orrin K. Arola Memorial Scholarship. This award was started about 12 years ago. I started it with some financial support from my mom. Oh, she's here. I didn't tell her we were doing this, by the way. I borrowed some money, Mom. You get $100 for this award. I did this to promote interest in social science. Students are selected on the basis of their positive attitude, creativity, analytical thinking, and general proficiency in history and its related subjects. Honestly, after last school year, when we didn't do any awards, I was kind of thinking of not doing it anymore. But we did the class rankings the other day, and one student did stand out. First of all, he was one of only two boys in the entire eighth grade to make the top 10, and he was the only boy to make the top 5. Most importantly, he was the only one of you guys in the entire eighth grade to get a perfect score on the Constitution test. Yeah, I'll clap for that. He is smart. He is funny. What? He already knows. I love it. I'm still praising you. He is smart. He is funny. He is well-liked by his peers. The winner of this history award is Edgar Tenorio. All right, next I'm presenting the ACE scholarships. These awards are sponsored by the Teachers Union. In a normal year, the junior high faculty selects one male, one female based on academic success, positive attitude, and leadership skills. Instead, this year we are selecting one student from AM, one from PM, and one from distance learning, which was chosen by Mrs. Bicknell. The AM student we selected has a really dry, I would say, maybe even you might say sarcastic sense of humor. And we love it. The truth is, though, even though she tries to hide it, she cares a lot about her work, and she takes a lot of pride in doing it. Also, I must admit, we're giving her special dispensation for surviving a family of older brothers. The winner for AM is Ella Fine. Okay, the PM student is another female, and I would say she has a really mature sensibility. Mr. Bailey described her today, we were talking this afternoon, as a cool cat, which is a way of saying that she is really easy for adults to talk to. She is confident in herself and well-respected by teachers and peers alike. I don't have this in my notes, but I do want to say she is a great writer, too, one of the best writers, really, I think I've ever taught. Don't you think, Ms. Garrison? The winner for the PM cohort is Emerson Arbelich. Okay, so this next part's gonna be fun because I forgot until the last minute to tell Mrs. Bicknell to pick somebody, which means I do not have the award here tonight to hand to this student. I will absolutely make sure that I get it in the mail tomorrow. So this is kind of fun. It's like a virtual award for the distance learning student. So you should be really good at that at this point. All right, I still want you to come up so I can shake your hand and you can get your picture. All right, here we go. When Ms. Bicknell asked me to pick a student, I told her to select someone with good academic standing, but also someone who added a dynamic element to the Zoom classes. I must say she made an excellent choice. This young man is quick-witted, lively, and energetic. When we were talking about him today, Mrs. Garrison said something amusing. She said, every cell of his body is full of oxygen. I know all the in-person teachers wish we had had him on campus this year. The winner for the Distance Learning Award is Landon Smith. Okay, we have arrived at the wrap. Okay, I'm gonna need. drink of water. All right. As always, before I begin, I want to give a couple of provisos here. Number one, no getting mad at me. You've been begging me for months to roast you. I warned you. And your exact response to me was, bring it. Well, I done brung it. Number two, this is a kind of a tricky one this year. I'm not going to lie. And if I mess it up, I put a lot of extra runway on the musical track there, so I might just circle around and try the lyric a second time. If that happens, just pretend you didn't hear it the first time. All right, number three, there's a lot of inside jokes. That's a problem we have every year, but it's compounded this year by the fact that it's not that the audience doesn't know all the jokes. Half of you aren't going to know the jokes. The AM kids aren't going to know the PM jokes, and the PM kids aren't going to know the AM jokes. So here's the rule. Just laugh at everything, even if it's not funny to you. Okay. I want to introduce DJ Swanton on the turntable. Don't start yet, Swanton. Hold on. Probably going to end up on the news for cultural misappropriation, but I got to have the gold chain. Backward hat. I feel so young. You want to hang out, Mr. Bailey? Hiding. Okay, a deep breath. All right, DJ, hit the beat. I'm giving myself a long intro here to get ready. Just waking up in the morning, gotta thank God. Don't know, but today seems kinda odd. Heard Dr. Fauci say, it's okay. Throw away your bottles of disinfectant spray. COVID getting better, that's what they all say. Headed off to school, it's gonna be a good day. Morning going well. AM class is rocking. Feeling so good. I got Wyatt talking, it's shocking. No, I mean, I actually had to electrocute him, to, like, get him to move. Savannah in the bathroom making TikTok. Darby so happy, got a funeral at 3 o'clock. Joe's heading home, got to play with all his toys. Gonna bug the neighbors with all his motorcycle noise. Somebody better put that boy back in school. I waved at Mr. Bailey across the junior high quad. The eighth grade girls all around him like a sun god. Let Brianna share about her weekend, but now she's telling stories and I'm wondering, will it ever end? Ruben comes to class and he's laughing at my meme. He's got new kicks and they're shining like a sunbeam. Maggie, thirsty for 60-year-old men, checking out Ralph Macchio again and again. Carson is outside and he's busy trying to flirt, but like an army runaway, the girls all desert. Don't be laughing, AM boys, you're also all alone. Cause when it comes to morning class, the boys are in the friend zone. AM done, and not a single fight. Grab myself a donut, an afternoon delight. Altogether, I think I have to say, things are going well, and it's gonna be a good day. All right. On the track with Swanner, PM bus arrives. Hear the gossip, buzzy buzz, 100 little beehives. Heard about Rose hitting home runs out of sight. She's so good, and she can hit them all night. Edgar asking questions to impress me, or is he wasting time? Filibustering. Test today, and I'm feeling kind of wary. I don't think they studied, and it might be kind of scary. It's not just a test of everything they know. Don't want them to fail, gotta get that 1.0. Questions look good. The essay's kind of scrawny. Manny did okay, but he sure isn't Johnny. Kenzie tore it up, so did Aniella. The rest of their class, you don't want me to tell ya. Riley breaks his Chromebook and my anger runs deep. So deep, no one else even makes a peep. Things could go bad, there's no doubt. But Miss Hayes shows up and she helps an anti-techie dog out. Got back to learning, my lesson flow churning, and then I see something quite concerning. Jason eating Takis, licking every finger, so gross. Must be the reason that Gabby said, adios. Sorry. Everyone outside, standing too close. And what's going on with Mariah and Carlos? Breaking up, breaking up. Nope, they're still together. Ship status changing faster than the weather. Yeah. PM class is done, not much left to say. Heading home, and I think it was a good day. Hop in the shower, just start relaxing. Gonna take a nap. I ain't capping with time to think. Everything's so clear. Time to move past our elevated COVID fear. The past 12 months, sometimes we're a bummer. So let's start next year right. Have a kick-ass summer.
The next award will be presented by Ms. Corrine Ellsworth.
Can't top that. Good evening, graduates and families. Tonight, I am representing the classified staff at both Mark Twain and Copperopolis schools. We are the cafeteria workers, office secretaries, technology specialists, librarians, custodians, bus drivers, and paraprofessionals. We have the great opportunity to be with all of the students in different settings at both Mark Twain and Copperopolis schools. Tonight, we have two scholarships to award. Each student will receive funds that will be deposited into their Bret Harte student account to go towards the purchase of a Bret Harte yearbook and a student body card. Each year we ask the classified staff to nominate students for these scholarships. As part of the nomination process, we have the opportunity to learn more about the students that are being nominated. I would like to introduce to you the two students that we have selected to receive the California School Employees Association Scholarship. I would like to first invite up Allison Pry. You can just stand right there. Right there. Right there. Okay. Allison is a happy, friendly young woman who enjoys being at school. She is an excellent student and works hard. Allison is responsible at school and at home and has recently taken up the art of cake decorating. Allison, I'm pleased to present you this scholarship from all of us at Mark Twain and Copperopolis Schools. Congratulations. Next, I would like to invite up Simon Akers. Simon is a friendly, happy young man who gets along with everyone. He is kind to those around him, which is a quality that is much needed today. He has a positive attitude towards school and chooses to stay out of the teenage drama that some students participate in. He has a good sense of humor and even laughs at Mr. Arola's jokes. Simon, I'm pleased to present you to you this scholarship. Congratulations and good luck at Bret Hart. Congratulations, Allie and Simon, and Mark Twain class of 2021.
I would like to introduce District Superintendent Mrs. Paula Wyant and reintroduce Mr. Pogue for the presentation of the Presidential Education Awards and Diplomas.
Good evening. It's great to be here. Congratulations, class of 2021. Our Presidential Education Awards. Honoring student achievement and hard work is the purpose of the Presidential Education Awards program. Since 1983, the program has provided individual recognition from the President and the U.S. Secretary of Education to those students whose outstanding efforts have enabled them to meet challenging standards of excellence. To be eligible for the President's Award for Educational Excellence, students must be in the top 5% of their graduating class. Students receiving this award are Mackenzie Sandoval. Lillian Ramos. Anayella Grisel. Allison Pry. Edgar Tenorio. This next award is to recognize students that show outstanding educational growth, improvement, and commitment in their academic subjects, but may not meet the criteria for the President's Award for Educational Excellence. These students will receive the President's Award for Educational Achievement. The students receiving this award are Boston Williams, and Kelsey Hoffman Martinez. Congratulations, one and all. With Mr. Pogue would now like to present the certificates to our valedictorians. Mackenzie Sandoval. Ramos. Allison Pry. Congratulations. Oh. And we have another award. Our salutatorian is Anaella Greisel.
At this time, and now I'd like the presentation of the 8th grade promotion diplomas.
Juliana.
Just a minute, let me.
Oh. Sorry about that.
This one?
Where's the bucket,
ready now?
Oh, we're
ready. Okay. We are ready now for our 8th grade graduates. Juliana Rose Amara Stone. Madison Parks Onstad. Allison Reese Pry. Brianna Diane Worth. Mackenzie Isabella Sandoval. Lillian Ramos. Anaella Arlene Elizabeth Greisel. Stephen Simmons. Manuel Edward Betancourt. Hudson Nunez. Moises Medrano. Anthony Arthur Eltringham. Woo! freshman Kelly Smith. Mariana Del Carmen Ramos. Savannah Hart McDowell Ferguson. Yvonne Burns. Isabella Nevea Valdez. Zaragail Harwell.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Do you want, this is Gab?
Yeah, this is Gabriella.
Oh, okay. Yeah, let's go back. Sorry. I'm so sorry, but you are so deserving to be called twice, or to go across twice. Gabriella, Elizabeth Marianne Fine. I am so sorry about that. Is this Ayla now?
Yeah, this is
okay. Okay. Ayla Zaragail Harwell. Melanie Barraza. Asiel Placentia. Shane Sterling Porter. Henry Terones. Juan Aaron Armendariz. Caden Anthony Sullivan. EJ Schwartz.
Congratulations.
Ryan Reed. Angela Sophia Barone. Mariah Elizabeth Colwell. Sydney Cole. Yes. Nancy Ryan Sullivan. Mackenzie Renee Button. Amelia Lynn Baxter. Kira Lynn Kraft. Dylan Anthony Morse Clark. Simon Edward Akers. Shane Gish. Conrad James Felix. Nico Anthony Valentine. Wyatt Jordan Skrobecki. Carson Gregory Thomasy. Malin Miro. Isabella Cecilia Vidalis. Kayliana Rose Erdman. Allie Samantha Lynn Sutton. Renee Hoffman Martinez. Jessica Marie Geisness. Johnson. Braxton Carl James Kite. Brian Andrew Folkerts. Anthony Geiser. Boston Cruz Williams. Betancourt. Julius Michael Hill. Angel Samora. Stella Reese Stammerjohn. Halia Sue Elzalde.
Go back to Jake. Thanks for being flexible.
Jade Nicole Linder.
Good job, baby girl. Say cheese.
Gabriella Martinez. Yeah. Savannah Suber. Grace Marie De Bruin. Emerson Grace Arbulich. Jesus Marcos Moncada. Kevin Wayne Reidenhauer II. Joseph William Hutchinson. Joey Rosselli. Riley Nathan Weckler. Joseph Martin St. Louis. Catherine Oates. Bailey Rose Goodrich. Elise Rivera.
This isn't embarrassing at all, guys.
Jackie Folks. Alyssa Marie Crumpton. Olivia Leanne Burke. the fourth. Emerson Magren. Jason Dale Whitaker. Marie Parks. Bailey Louise Dana. Isabella Doris Becker. Our first recipient in this row has a broken leg in the back, but we would like her to stand. Ava Dylan Darby. Just recently in an accident. Congratulations. Magdalene May Purvis Howard. Danielle Tyler.
Eighth graders and school board president and school board, please stand. As principal of Mark Twain Elementary School, I certify these eighth graders have met all requirements set forth by our Mark Twain Union School District Governing School Board. By the power vested in you as the Governing School Board President, I hereby request you declare the class of 2021 to be promoted from Mark Twain Elementary School.
I declare you're graduated, kids.
I've been building a house. I filled it with all the things that I could live without. I've been thinking about how the walls come down and the ceiling crashed around my feet, broken
nothing that really mattered to me. Yeah, yeah. And now I see that it's you I needed all along. Maybe I'm too late and gone, it always seems to go. I'll be breaking in two, I don't know what I do. If I didn't have you, if I didn't have you, thought I had nothing to lose. But that's not the truth, I don't know what I do. If I didn't have you, even as the words came out, as they fall, I wanna take them back. I know I let you down, and it's all that I've been thinking about. I get I messed it up.